Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's talk about using multiple desktops on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 600 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So one of the most powerful features of your Mac is the ability to have multiple desktops. But a lot of Mac users don't know about this feature and they could really use it. It's particularly useful if you have only one screen like most MacBook or iMac users do. You can use this to simulate having multiple displays and it could really help you clean up your workspace and be more efficient. So take a look at what I've got here. I have all these different windows here open on this screen. But what I can do is get rid of this mess by using multiple desktops. Now this feature is sometimes called Mission Control, sometimes it's called Spaces. Other people call it multiple desktops or using many desktops. It doesn't matter what you call it. The way to see your desktops is to use the keyboard shortcut Control Up Arrow. And this brings you into a mode called Mission Control. Mission Control gives you an overview of all your desktops. You can see at the top there I have one desktop, desktop one. And if I move my cursor over it, it'll actually show me a small representation of the desktop. Below, I'll see all of the windows in the desktop, but kind of moved around so I can see them all clearly so they're not overlapping each other. To add a second desktop, all I need to do is click the plus button here, and it adds desktop two, and you can see that's empty. I could switch between them by simply clicking on them. So I could use Control Up Arrow to get here, and then click on desktop two, and now I'm at desktop two. Control Up Arrow takes me back here and I can click on desktop one to go back to desktop one. But a much easier way to do it is to use control and right or left to quickly fly between these multiple desktops. On a trackpad, the default shortcut is to use three fingers on your trackpad and swipe with three fingers left or right to move between them. But you have to look in system preferences to make sure you have that enabled. So that's under trackpad and then more gestures, and you could see here swipe between full screen apps. But what this really means is any kind of desktop. You also have Mission Control swipe up with three fingers. So instead of using Control Up Arrow, I could simply do a three finger up swipe to get to the same place. Now I could add a third desktop if I want, and then I can then use Control Right Arrow to go to the second one, Control Right Arrow to go to the third one, and then Left Arrow to go back to the other two. Now to move something to another desktop, I can do that one of several ways. I could actually click and drag this window, and while I'm still dragging, I can use Control and Right Arrow to move to another desktop and drop it there. That's kind of hard to do, to hold the trackpad and hit two buttons on the opposite sides of the keyboard. So a better way to do it is to go into Mission Control, and from there you can move your cursor up to the top here to reveal all of these desktops. You could drag from the bottom here onto another desktop. So I can put the Safari window here on desktop 3. So now I've got desktop 3 with this Safari window on it. I can Control Left Arrow to desktop 2 with this Maps window on it, and then Control Left Arrow back to my first desktop with all of these windows on it. And I can use Mission Control to easily move things around. So while in here I can still use Control Left Arrow and Right Arrow to go between desktops, and then I can drag any window I see below here to any of these desktops to move it there. So you can see how this kind of simulates having three displays. Here's my first display, here's my second display, here's my third display. It's like I've got three screens even though I just have one MacBook sitting on my lap or one iMac sitting on my desk. I can only see one at a time, so it's not as good as having three displays, but it does help me clean up my workspaces. And note that you can have multiple windows from the same app on different workspaces. So here's a Finder window and here's a Finder window. I could take this one and move it to another desktop here. So I can put that on desktop 2. So desktop 2 might now have this Maps window open here and a Finder window open with files that relate to the task I'm doing here. On this desktop I've got a separate Finder window open for doing other things. So you can group the windows by what task you're doing. Maybe one's for writing, one's for doing research, another's for email. Now you can also easily rearrange these in Mission Control. So for instance, if I wanted to swap these two desktops, I could just click and drag them there. Notice the names don't stick with the desktop. So desktop 1, desktop 2, desktop 3, it's about the order they're in. If I switch 3 with 2, they just get renamed, and so they're still 1, 2, and 3. Now there are actually three different types of things that you could have here in Mission Control. We've only looked at one of them, which is a full desktop. A second one is an actual full screen app. So let's go and create another Safari window here. I'll click on Safari and you notice it jumps right to that desktop with Safari on it. I'll open up a new Safari window and let's go to MACMOST on this window. Now I can go full screen with this app by clicking the green button here or going to View and then enter Full Screen. Either one will take that app full screen. The menu bar is hidden. I can get to it by moving my cursor to the top. The dock is hidden, but I can get to it by moving my cursor to the bottom. But otherwise this window takes up the entire screen. I can't change the window size. It goes from edge to edge. Now if I go into Mission Control, you can see now I've got my Desktop 1, Desktop 2, Desktop 3, and there's that full screen app. It goes in the list as well. So that's the second type of thing that could be here. A third type of thing is anytime you use split view, which is like full screen, but with two apps instead of one. So let's say I've got photos open here and the finder here, and I want to put these both in a split view desktop. I can hover over the green button here, and then I have the ability to tile window to the left or to the right. So let's move this finder window to the right side of the screen, and then it has me select another window that was on that desktop for the left side. And now I've got split view. If I go to Control, up arrow for Mission Control, you can see I've got Desktop 1, 2, and 3. I've got that full screen Safari here. And I've got the split view with Photos and Finder. I can drag the middle line here depending upon which apps I'm using. In this case, the Finder can get pretty small on the right, but the Photos can only go to about halfway. But now I've got this one desktop that is using two apps kind of sharing the screen. You can use Mission Control to exit this. Matter of fact, Mission Control is a really handy way to have both of these apps leave their split screen view. Otherwise, if I just hit the green button on one, the other one gets stuck in full screen mode. But here I can click here, and now it puts these both back on the original desktop they were on. I can get rid of any of these by using Mission Control and clicking on the X here. I can say get rid of Desktop 3, and you can see that goes away. I can exit Safari's full screen mode by clicking here, and that goes away as well. So there are a lot of different ways to use these. Some people like just to have apps in full screen mode. So they'll have everything full screen mode. And then they'll be able to use Control, left arrow, right arrow to go between full screen windows for each app. And it's actually no problem if you want to drag and drop, because you can click to drag something like this link here. And if you just go to another desktop using Control right arrow here, I can still drop it there even though you've got apps in full screen mode. Other people like to use multiple desktops to separate their workspaces. So maybe you've got, you know, your Safari window open here and with Photos because you're working on those two apps in this one. And then maybe create another one where you're doing a writing project and you have a Safari window open for research for that. Some people will have 5, 10, 15 different desktops open, each one for a different project they're working on. So how you use this is really up to you. There's so many different options. You can ask 10 different people how they use this and you'll find 10 different ways of using it. Now there are a lot of options you should know about. We go to System Preferences and then Mission Control. First notice you've got the keyboard shortcut for Mission Control here. And you can set it to something else if you want. We're going to look at more keyboard shortcuts in a minute. Then you've got these checkboxes here. You've got automatically rearrange spaces based on the most recent use. A lot of people are really frustrated by this. They don't realize it's an option, so they have it turned on. And they complain that their desktops and full screen apps are always switching which position they're in. A lot of times we keep the order in mind mentally and we can use Control and left and right arrow to switch between them. But having this turned on will really mess that up. There's also the checkbox for when switching an application, switch to that space. So I've got the Maps app here, for instance. If I go to this desktop, the Maps app isn't there. So if I use Command Tab and go to Maps, it's going to jump me to that space there. What if I wanted to open another Maps window? So what I can do here is turn that off. Now I can go over here. I could switch to the Maps app and you can notice it doesn't take me to that space. I am running Maps now and I can go and create a new window in this desktop. Group windows by application simply means that when you go to Mission Control, Control up arrow, notice how the two Finder windows are together here? Well, if you have that turned off and you do Control up arrow, now they're apart. So it's only a tiny difference. And finally, we've got a big one here if you've got multiple displays. With this checked, every display has its own set of spaces. So you can have two screens and go to one screen and then swap around and have multiple desktops and things on that one screen, leaving your first screen with the same desktop. But if you turn this off, then both of your screens will act as one big desktop, and switching from one desktop to another switches both screens. Now, this is such a big, massive change that if you were to change it here, you can see it says requires logout. Unchecking or checking this means you have to log out, log back in to see that difference. Now for keyboard shortcuts, go into System Preferences, Keyboard, and then go to Shortcuts, and there's an entire section here for Mission Control. So you can find the main Mission Control shortcut there, but also you could find the Move Left and Move Right shortcuts and keyboard shortcuts for the first 5 desktops you create. Also, back in Mission Control here, you can click on Hot Corners and you can assign a hot corner to Mission Control. So this means when I move my cursor up to that corner, it activates Mission Control just like hitting Control up arrow does. Now there's one more big control that we haven't seen anywhere here because it appears in the dock of all places. If you control click on an icon in the dock and go to Options, you'll see Assign To, and then you can set it to All Desktops, a specific desktop, or None. Now in this case I have 3 displays, so it also has an option for each one of those displays. But let's ignore that for now. If I were to set this app, in this case Maps, to All Desktops, what I get is something interesting. This window here for Maps, if I go to the second desktop, it's there in the same place. The window appears everywhere, so I can move it over here to the right, go back to this desktop, and you can see it's moved over to the right. I could resize it, move to this desktop, and you can see it basically exists across all desktops. Or if you go and assign it to a specific desktop, what will happen is it stays on that desktop even if you, say, quit that app, go to another desktop, and let's launch this app again. It's going to go back to that first desktop. It's going to make this app stick on that desktop. Even if I go here and I try to switch to that app, no matter what my system preference is, it's going to switch to that desktop when I create a new window. You can see it's going to force all new Maps windows into that desktop. I could still go and move this window to another desktop afterwards. So now you can see I've got them both there. But if I create a new window, it's always going to do it on the desktop that I've specified here in the dock. So that's a look at using multiple desktops on your Mac. You notice there are a ton of different options and a ton of different ways to use this. There is no one right way. You could decide not to use this at all. You could decide to have all your apps in full screen mode. You could decide to have tons of desktops with different windows or split views or anything you want to do or any combination thereof. It's a tool that's built for you to use as you want. The only thing I would say is if you're not using multiple desktops now, you should maybe give it a try. If you don't like it, just stop using it. But you may find that it can improve your productivity once you get used to it. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.